Hi everyone, welcome back to Salesforce Tech Book. Today we are going to discuss the topic is Lightning Message Service. Before we are going to start the session, please stay healthy, stay safe. Please go to WHO website for latest information on COVID-19 outbreak. As part of this session, what we are going to discuss and what we are going to learn. We are going to learn Lightning Message Service, what is Lightning Message Service, and what is Lightning Message Channel, and how can we create a Lightning Message Channel. Okay, and I'm going to create a series of sessions for all the examples with the Lightning Message Service with Visual Force and RA components and Lightning Web components and all together also. You can follow all the series of Lightning Message Service. Now, what is Lightning Message Service? Lightning Message Service is used to communicate across DOM between RA components and Visual Force pages and Lightning Web components. So it is based on a new type of metadata, Lightning Message Channel. Through Lightning Message Channels, it can provide the communication between Visual Force and RA and LWC. That means with the help of this, you don't need to define different kind of mechanisms for providing the communication between LWC to RA, RA to Visual Force, and Visual Force to Visual Force, RA to RA, LWC to LWC. You can use the same communication mechanism, that is Lightning Message Service, with the help of Lightning Message Channel to provide the communication from Visual Force to RA, RA to LWC, LWC to RA. It's cross communication between different UI technologies. It will be helpful for that. It's a very useful feature. Now, what is Lightning Message Channel? It is kind of custom metadata type. It's a kind of another metadata, as I told you here. It's a new type of metadata, and it will be useful for providing the communication, okay, through Lightning Message Service. And it is lightweight, and it is packageable also. And then, how can we create a Lightning Message Channel? You can't create this Lightning Message Channel from Salesforce user interface for now, but you can create this Lightning Message Channel from VS Code. Okay, how we can create? You just need to create a directory called Message Channels under default directory, and then you can give or you can create a file with the name, that is Lightning Message Channel. Okay, you can give a name of the Lightning Channel, Lightning Message Channel, whatever you want, with extension dot message channel hyphen meta dot xml. Okay, if you see here, sample message channel is my message channel name, and the extension of this file is this. And when you want to refer this channel in either Visual Force or ARA or LWC components, then you have to use name of your message channel by giving suffix as underscore underscore C. Now please remember, it is not a custom object. Okay. Now, how it looks like? What is the sample definition of this message channel? This is the sample definition of message channel. It starts with the Lightning Message Channel tag, and it has master label and is exposed attribute or tag to expose this true, this to expose this message channel or not, and description of this. And this master label represents your message channel name. Now, so basically by this, if you see this is the information of your message channel, and you are giving the name and you are exposing this message channel. But how can you pass the data with the help of this? So by using Lightning Message fields in message channel, where you can create. So in Lightning Message field, you will have field name and description. How we can represent, how we can add these fields into our message channel file. So let's go to another slide. If you see here, until this point, we already saw. And to define your fields or attributes for holding the message and for holding the payload, when someone wants to publish some message to another components, then you should have lightning message fields defined in your object, in your lightning message channel file. So field name, you can give any name what you want, and description. Okay, field name is always required, and here record data and description. You can create any number of fields here. Okay, now we have message channel file, and it has two fields. One is record ID and record data. And how can we create? Let's see everything practically now. Now we know theoretically how we can create a message channel by using by creating a folder that is message channels, and then under that you have to create a file with the extension dot message channel hyphen meta.xml, and then you have to define our attributes in that file to hold the message to pass between components, right? Let's do the same thing practically. So simply you have to create a folder. What is that folder name? You should give only this name, and here under default folder, force app main default folder, new folder. This is the name of folder, and under this you can create your message channel. Here my message channel name is sample message channel. You can create your message channel with any name, but extension should be the same. So this is my message channel. Now I'm going to give sample definition first. This is the man. Done. And along with this, I want to give fields also, right? So let's give fields. The first field is record ID, and another field is this one. Record data. Now I defined attributes or fields for this lightning message channel. Now it is ready to accept and publish. It is ready to accept the message and publish to another component. So what is the main advantage here about this lightning message channel? Basically, you can publish a message from Visual Force Space to Lightning Aura component or Lightning Web component. And you can publish Aura component to Lightning Web component or Visual Force. You can publish message from Lightning Web component to Aura or Visual Force Space. It makes your life easy to provide the communication between different kind of components. If you have already Visual Force pages, you can, if you are moving to Salesforce, moving to Lightning Experience from Salesforce Classic, still you can communicate information from Visual Force Space to other Lightning Experience UI technologies like LWC, Aura. Same way, vice versa, you can communicate to from LWC to Visual Force and Aura to Visual Force page also on Lightning Experience pages, Lightning pages. Okay, please remember this point. This is how it will be useful. This is how you can create. As part of the session, what we learned, what is message Lightning Message Service, how it will be useful, and what is the main purpose to provide the communication between three different technologies, UI technologies, Lightning Web Components, Aura Components, and Visual Force, and how we can create Lightning Message Channel. Okay, this is how we can create, and these are all the references. I will provide this in my video description. You can have a look into it, and I will provide a series of sessions on the Lightning Message Service in Visual Force and Lightning Web Component and Aura Components individually, and then I will combine everything together in another session, how it will be communicating between all components with one message channel. Okay, please go through this. All the best. Please subscribe to Salesforce TechBook.